So we're still on NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement. And last time we stopped at chapter 98, subchapter 2 provisions, and they also relate to NAFTA, but they're somewhat different from the rest of the NAFTA provisions that we talked about so far. If we take a look at the Code of Federal Regulations, recall that NAFTA provisions under Part 181. Well, if we go to that subpart F, goods return after repairs and alterations, this is what we are talking about for the NAFTA provisions. And they are available under Chapter 98, subpart 2, 98.02. And here is something interesting that we need to keep in mind. For the purpose, and this is note 3D. For the purposes of subheading 98.02 and 98.0040-3450, the rates of duty in the special subcolumn, followed by CAO Mexico in parentheses, shall apply only to any goods which are returned to the United States after having been repaired or altered. Repaired or altered is a term of art. We shall cover it in a bit later. In Canada or Mexico, whether or not, and here's the punchline, whether or not such goods are goods of Canada or goods of Mexico under the terms of General Note 12 to the tariff schedule. Essentially, what this note says is that don't worry about General Note 12, because this is different. It's still kind of like part of NAFTA, but because they're repaired or returned, or they're the goods that have been underwent a reparation or alteration processes, we are not going to worry about the tariff shift method or the other stuff. We are just going to worry about the fact that it went to Canada or Mexico and has been returned to the United States. So CA or MX symbols are applicable. The caveat here, of course, is that we have a, if we go to chapter 98, to the very beginning, we will see that of course, these provisions, including the provisions that we just talked about, must be coupled with the real HTS US number. And when you declare it on CBP form 7501, either online or electronically or on paper, there is no way of avoiding the actual HTS number. So this one would be repair or alterations number, right? And this one would be the number providing for the good which was repaired to alter it. And for this one, you will place MX or Canada, Mexico or Canada symbol. And for this one, you would place the country of origin. So really, there is no getting away from the country of origin per se. But for the purposes of this particular HTS number, you can disregard the general note 12. And it plays out in the HTS table. See, chapter 98.02 doesn't only provide for Mexico and United States, but here's how it plays out in the HTS US table. So you have repairs and alterations provisions, you have a warranty and without warranty, right? And you have Canada and Mexico here. Notice, for the ones without warranty, Mexico is the only country that's in the game. Canada is not listed. So if you're doing Canada, warranty is required. All right, now with this background, let's go back to the outline. So the point is that this general note 12T process is not required. And here is how it plays out in the world of licensed customs broker examination. So examiners ask, fabric produced in Hong Kong is sent to China, where it is cut into pieces and assembled into t-shirts. The completed t-shirts are sold to and imported into the United States. After being entered into the United States, the t-shirts are exported to Mexico for screen printing. So only the screen printing, so they put some kind of logo or label or some kind of photograph on the t-shirt. And after this, it is being returned to the United States. So under the HTS US 9802, what is the country of origin that should be shown on the 7501, which is the entry summary, when the t-shirts are coming back from Mexico, right? So usually the question would be, is the country of origin Hong Kong or China? Of course, we know that Hong Kong, although it is part of China, it is treated as a separate customs territory. But most likely because it was only the fabric that was in China and the actual making was in Hong Kong, it is likely the country of origin is to be Hong Kong. Without engaging into tariff shifting or details like that, this is just a rule of thumb, because this is where most essential operation took place. Of course, for textiles, we have to engage in tariff shifting methodology under Section 102.21 of the Code of Federal Regulations. But this is just a shortcut. So here, remember, we do not need to engage in that general Note 12 analysis or a general Note 12T analysis for that matter. All we need to do is to know that it has been altered or repaired. Here, it most likely the alteration provision applies. So if we go to 9802, most likely it would be articles exported for alterations, and this would be the applicable HTS number. You would put Mexico and you would claim duty free for the alterations part. Of course, we know that for the 9802 provisions, whenever we declare, the duty that you pay is the duty you pay only on the value added portion, such as repairs or alterations, not on the whole product upon the importation. So, but here you don't even need to pay that, because just by virtue of it coming to Mexico, you can claim Mexico, and it kind of makes sense in a way, because if you think about it, since you are only paying duty at least under the general column, then it would make sense to pay duty only on the stuff that have been done in that country. So in a way, country of origin for the stuff, if that thinking methodology is helpful, country of origin for that stuff that have been done in the country is the country of origin for that particular purposes, in this case repairs and alterations, right? So in here, the job was done in Mexico, the printing job was done in Mexico, the alteration job was done in Mexico. The duty, if any, you would claim, it would be only for that Mexican portion, although you still have to declare that Chinese Hong Kong t-shirt with a regular HTS US number, because there is a coupling process. But that's totally fine. But the only relevant portion is where it comes from. Here, it's Mexico. To put it another way, what's the country of export? Country of export is Mexico. Or if it was Canada, then it wouldn't qualify, because warranty is required, of course. But in this case, it's Mexico, so it qualifies. So we're good on this one. All right, so going back to the question, what's the country of origin for the t-shirts that are imported back to the United States? The correct answer is Mexico. United States, well, nothing was done there. Hong Kong, most likely for the t-shirts itself, but not for the repairs and alterations for the 9802 purposes. So that's the one is wrong. NA and NAFTA, there is no such symbol. It is either United States, Mexico, or Canada, CA. NA, it doesn't exist. So this one is obviously incorrect. And China CN, well, most likely it would not be a correct answer choice, even if you didn't apply Chapter 9802, because it was only the fabric, not the t-shirts. But in here it's obviously wrong, because we are only focused on the Chapter 9802 question, and here is the buzzword over here, 9802. So this is how examiners test on one of those issues in on the 9802 issue in the customs broker exam. So to drive a point home, we also need to see the definition of repairs and alterations. And for definition of repairs and alterations, you do not go to the HTSUS, chapter 98, subchapter 2. You actually go to the Code of Federal Regulations here, section 18164. And section 18164 says that repairs and alterations means, they pretty much give you the buzzwords, and a lot of those buzzwords are most likely, if you are being tested, the customs examiners are likely to use those buzzwords. They will not imagine anything funny, although sometimes they can. But let's take a look. So the buzzwords are restoration, addition, renovation, redyeing, cleaning, restellarizing, so the medical supplies probably, and other treatment which does not destroy the essential characteristics or create newly commercially different good from the good that was exported from the United States. If this sounds familiar, you are probably right, because those are the concepts that dealt, although from the other side, in when we talked about concept of substantial transformation. The substantial transformation means new article of commerce. Here, it's the same side, but it requires, in order for repairs or alterations to qualify, it requires it to be fall short of that substantial transformation requirement. So, next question clarifies how this repairs and alteration concept is being tested on the exam. And it comes from the negative. But let's read the fact pattern. Let's read the whole thing, which says, PhoneMex is planning to set up a telephone repair production facility in Mexico. PhoneMex will return all telephones and repaired or produced directly to the United States. So they're going to Mexico for repairs and alterations. Remember, warranty is irrelevant for Mexico, so let's continue reading. The returning telephones are not entitled to duty-free entry as originating goods under NAFTA, but we do not need that. Recall that if we go to the chapter 9802, heading 9802, and we go to that note 3D, it clearly says that that whether or not such goods are of Canada or Mexico under the terms of General Note 12, meaning that no, you really do not need to engage in the Note 12 analysis. So although one can argue this is a part of the agreement, simply because if you look at the section 18164, which is under NAFTA, right, it really talks about repairs and alterations, the term that we saw in the outline, right? So it's kind of clumsy way, I would argue, to put it. We kind of see the point that customs examiners are trying to make, right? But in other words, it's clumsy, because the section 18164 kind of codifies that chapter 9802 provisions for NAFTA. It's kind of like part of NAFTA, but it has its own separate treatment, separate set of rules. But with that in mind, let's read on. So, which phone MAX operations would not qualify? So we're looking for the one that is not. As repairs or alterations entitling the return telephones to the duty-free treatment. So, all right, we know the buzzwords. We know that the requirement must, the product, whatever is made, it must fall short of new article of commerce, of new product. And so let's start out our analysis from A. Fully functional used telephones would be exported from the United States to Mexico, where they would be modified slightly by adding redial capability. All right, so no new telephone emerged, only slight modification, no new article of commerce, so this is fine. A fits 9802 criteria, and again, we're looking for the one that's not. So moving further. B, telephone sub-assemblies would be exported from the United States to Mexico for assembly into completed telephones. All right. Here you have telephone parts. Telephone parts would go to Mexico and they would become completed product, right? So B is kind of questionable because you have sub-assemblies, you have parts, and you have the operation, even though it's an assembly operation. If the assembly operation is complicated enough, then it would qualify as the substantial transformation. So the simple assembly operations, of course, do not qualify. So if you're just riveting the screws, that will not do. But it looks like sub-assemblies dealing with the telephones. Telephone is a high technologically relatively high-tech equipment, so we may deal with the concept of substantial transformation. Also, looking at the buzzwords, restoration, addition, renovation, redying, cleaning, restellarizing, other treatment, most likely if none of the buzzwords are applicable, addition may be applicable, right? But here the focus is on the change in essential character, and the point B does kind of indicate that from parts you're going to be bringing back the whole working units, and the whole working units is just too far out because it does look like a new article of commerce, ready to use telephone sets. So B, I wouldn't eliminate it right away. I would put a question mark because the concept of substantial transformation is tricky. It's kind of fluid and it's subjective. So here, in this particular example, this example is a good example of analytical perspective through the process of elimination, right? So we eliminated A because we knew that there was this buzzword slide, right? It signals to us no substantial transformation. Here there's no such thing. So we put a question mark and read on. Non-functional used telephones would be exported to the United States from the US to Mexico, where they would be restored to their original condition. So here you have telephones, although they are non-functional, they are still complete units. Here you have incomplete units, you have parts. But here you have a complete unit, and all was going to be done to them is the repair. The essential character of the telephone does not change, the end use does not change, the product itself does not change, it's just being repaired. So C looks like in line with A, is not our choice because C provides for something which is. It does fit that repair or alteration clause. D, black and beige telephones would be exported from the United States to Mexico for repairing in more popular colors. So this is explicitly provided in the buzzword choice because we have redying, right? Redying or changing the color is something which is mere repair or alteration. So B is obviously not our answer choice because I'm sorry, D is no, obviously not our answer choice, because this is just mere alteration, if you will. And lastly, E, telephones having defective or unacceptable ringtones would be exported from Mexico to Mexico from United States to install inexpensive, more pleasant and appealing sounding device. All right. So here all has been changed. The sound is again, it's in a line of slight modification provisions. It's not changing the essential character. The reason you buy a phone is to communicate. It's not to play music. Even if it plays music like many smartphones do currently nowadays, still doesn't change the essential character. So E is also not our choice. So with this in mind, we can be more certain to pick for B as a correct answer choice by eliminating all the other ones that stand out on the side of repairs or alterations as opposed to the side of changing essential character. So for this one, B is a correct answer choice.